Every application is put together using components like a programming language, a database, and a server, and all of that. And when you put it all together, we call it the stack. And there's lots of different stacks. There's Ruby and .NET, PHP, and it just goes on and on. So how do you know which stack is best for you? That's what we're going to talk about today. Okay, so if you're a tech-savvy person and you already know all the different stacks and what they're about, then this video isn't really for you. But if you're like most people and you're not really sure exactly what a stack is, let alone how to make a decision about which one to use, here are a few tips for you. Number one, be sure to decide what is right for you and for your application. Don't let your developers decide. Developers are always going to choose the stack that they're good at, or that they like, or that they want to use, or they want to try, or they're comfortable with. It's not necessarily the same as what is best for you and what you need. Number two, unless you have a really specific reason to do so, stick with the mainstream. Pick something popular. It doesn't have to be the most popular, but try not to go for an obscure stack. It's going to cause a lot of trouble in the future. Number three, don't feel obligated to be cutting edge or very hip or use the absolute newest stack. It's probably not necessary to do that, and it can be a very expensive thing to want to be on the cutting edge of technology and use the absolute newest stack. So don't feel like you need to do that. And remember, for every stack out there, someone's going to come along and say, oh, this is the best stack, and that stack sucks. And then someone else is going to come along and say, no, that stack sucks, this is the best stack. The reality is that each one has its own strengths and weaknesses, and it's about figuring out which one fits best for you. Here are some examples of some popular stacks. There's PHP MySQL. This is the most popular stack in the world. There are loads of developers available. It works well, it's stable, it's cheap to host and to own. It can be harder to scale to really huge size, but you have to really get big for that to be a problem. Then you've got something like Ruby on Rails. This is the most popular of the really new generation frameworks. It's easy to learn, it's very fast, hugely scalable, and there's a lot of hype about Ruby on Rails. It can be harder to find truly good developers as a result, and they're going to be expensive because they're really in demand. The culture around Ruby is geared much more towards startups and people that like the newest stuff. Then you've got a stack like the .NET Microsoft stack, and it doesn't get less hip than this stack, but it's actually a great stack. There are loads of professional developers available, and their culture is a little more mature, more experienced, and they're more geared towards big business and government and education and things like that. There's lots of integrations with all types of enterprise systems, so it can be a very, very good choice in some cases. And it goes on and on. There's so many more, like there's Node and Django, and there's Mongo and Cassandra, tons of different stacks to choose from. So when you're choosing a stack, think about what it is that you really need. Is your application really all that complex? Are you really going to have millions of users one day? Is that realistic? Do you need that? Can you afford to use the cutting edge stuff? Is that necessary? Do you want to make that investment? Are you trying to impress anyone, like investors or attracting a particular type of developers? Or maybe you want to hire your own developers and manage them. So you want to get a stack that is already known to you. So if your needs are very simple and you don't need to scale up to the Twitter level, PHP might be a great choice. If you have crazy scalability needs, you might go for a framework like Node or Django, or Ruby, something like that. And if you want to align yourself with government and education, a Microsoft stack might be a great fit. The important thing to remember is to make sure that your stack fits your business and that you own the decision on which stack to go with. Don't be stuck in a stack just because somebody else likes it.